Hi guys! Today I wanted to share with you more packaging ideas for your orders and few examples of little freebies that you can add to personalize your orders and make them a bit more special. Enjoy watching! I start packing with the outer box and labeling. I've been using these small cardboard boxes for over a year now. They fit large letter size, are very convenient and compact, and are easier to recycle. I found them on Amazon website. I like to label the boxes first, so I can then sort and pack my orders easily. For that, I'm currently using this little printer by Phomemo, which has been kindly sent to me to test out and give my review. I haven't been using any printers before, mostly because of their cost and size. I used to address each order by hand, which of course adds a lovely personal touch. However, I must admit that lately addressing orders by hand has been consuming way too much time and proved to be no longer efficient. This can become an issue, especially during busy holiday season. So that would be my first and foremost opinion on this printer, I guess. It saves me surprisingly a lot of time. It's super easy to use. As you can see, it's tiny and portable, and it operates via Bluetooth. So if you're looking for a handy, inexpensive label printer, this can be an option for you. Let me show you how I use it. You create the labels in the Phomemo app. I usually have mine saved so I can access them quickly. You can edit the text in the editor, see the preview, and then print it out. You can adjust the size accordingly to the label size you're using at the moment, because there are several sizes you can choose from. The printing is quick and easy. I haven't had any issues using the device and the app, and I can say that overall I am very happy. Now let's move on to the actual packaging inside the box. There are many ways to package your jewelry. You can use pretty cards and cut them to size to display earrings or necklaces, which you can then wrap in tissue paper. You can use organza bag or linen pouches. Great thing about the linen pouches is that you can paint them or print something on them to customize them. And if you're feeling fancy, you can always order your own customized branded jewelry boxes with or without your logo. I've been ordering my boxes for well over a year now at Westpac, and I've been super happy with them. Next, I will add branded materials. These can be your business cards and information, thank you or care instructions cards. If you'd like to see how I designed mine for free online, check out the video in the right top corner. Because these are printed, I like to add a handwritten thank you card as well. Now, onto the freebies ideas. Let's be real, who doesn't like free stuff and little gifts, right? Even a tiny little extra thing will make your order more special and your customer happy. Here are some things that you can add depending on the order value. Lovely delicious teas, polishing cloths, ring sizers, scented or unscented candles, little bottles with crystals or dried flowers, some larger crystals, and you can reuse those little plastic bags that you probably receive with your supplies. They are excellent to store jewelry to protect it from tarnishing, so you can add them to your order as well. I will now show you an example of how I pack some of the orders. You can put some lovely tissue paper inside and add all of the little bits and bobs that you want to include in this order. Then you can wrap it up and put a washi tape on top to seal it. Another way would be to use a little cord and to add a personalized thank you card with a little bell. I think this one would be really great for holiday season. That adds a little bit more festive touch to your order. If you want to take your order to the next level, you can have your logo made in the form of a stamp that you can then use with wax. I find it really lovely and like very, very special. It gives this old vibe of old packages and sealed letters. So I find it really great. So you would take few bits of wax and then use a special metal spoon to melt it. Usually this little candle is enough, and then you can pour it and press your stamp on top of it to achieve a little seal like this one. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you Phomemo for sending me the printer. It has been really helping me a lot, and I am really happy to be using it for my orders now. So yeah, thank you all so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!